Right, good morning, everybody. Hope you're all up and you've all remembered the hour, the extra hour or lost an hour. I don't know. It doesn't really matter, does it? So anyway, good morning. Lovely to see you all. If you can just put your comments in and say hi. Towards the end of the service today, Jan will be doing questions and answers. So if you've got any questions, please post them as a comment. And we will pick those up later on, hopefully, the ones that we can. Always say, never forget, you know, no question is daft if you don't know the answer. Simple as that. So don't think, oh, I can't ask that, I'll be silly. The way people learn is by asking questions. So no, you won't be silly. All right. So anyway, welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome those who are watching us now live. Welcome to those who will be watching us later on. Doesn't matter. And today we've got the lovely Janet Ridge from Wareham with us. Good morning, Janet.
Good morning, Lawrence. And how are you?
Lovely. Yourself?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you.
Good, good, good. So our format for the service this morning is Jan will open up in prayer, and then we'll go into a healing part where we can all join together and sit out and send out and receive healing also. Then I'll hand back to the lovely Jan for a reading and an address. After that, over to you, open platform. Anybody wants to ask anything, please do. And again, I can never stress this enough. You know, no question is daft. If you don't know the answer to something and you get the opportunity to ask that, that's probably daft if you don't. But if you don't know the answer, or you just want somebody else's opinion, or you want somebody else to confirm your own opinion, the only way you can do that is by talking and communicating. So let's soldier on. So without further ado, I will now hand over to Jan for the opening prayer, please, Jan.
Thank you, Lawrence. Good morning, everyone. Would you like to join with me in prayer? Heavenly Father, divine and loving Spirit, we give our thanks to you that during our days of uncertainty, we know that we are being guided and loved by our family in the spirit world. We ask that in whatever way we can, we are able to help reassure and encourage each other to lessen any fear and anxiety and show respect and kindness to all. We give our thanks especially to all those working so tirelessly on our behalf, the doctors, nurses, carers and government. We face uncertain times. Please give them the strength and courage to carry on with their healing work. And may we also send healing to them in their time of need. We think of all those that have lost loved ones, not only in our country, but across the world. We know that your love surrounds us all, and that after our tears, we may all begin to rejoice together. We also remember at this time our animal kingdom, for they too are conscious of the changes in our world. Together, the whole of humanity stands together. And we're not just going to stand together now, today, but for always. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jan. That was beautiful. And as always, spirit work absolutely beautifully. Believe it or believe it not, really don't mind. I know it's the truth. So does Jan. There was no conferring on what the theme of today was going to be about. But obviously, spirit have brought it together so beautifully. So that prayer, absolutely heartfelt. Thank you, Jan. I know the emotion was there. I was feeling it. And now if we can go over and switch our energies over now to that healing vibration. Remember, healing is channeled through you. It comes from the heart of all creation. It's totally unlimited. The only thing that limits it is our own mind, our own thoughts, our own perceptions. If we can lay those to one side, that healing energy will flow unbounded and unlimited. All right, so moving into our healing time now, please. Just sit quietly if you can. If you can't, don't worry, you can do this at a later date. It doesn't matter, all right? But just link in with that God of your own understanding. Divine and infinite spirit, We give thanks for this knowledge that we are able to access the power of healing, and that healing energy will manifest itself in the way and in accord to your divine plans for all things. We ask for those dear ones that serve humanity in whichever way or form, that their energies are turned towards the positive side, the doers, the ones who tend the hospitals, the ones that keep us fed, the ones that keep our streets clean, the ones that govern our countries. All these people, all these thoughts, all these energies, we ask for that healing balm to surround and uplift them. For it is through the positive energies that we achieve and we will overcome. We send out our thoughts and our heartfelt desires to uplift those dear ones that have crossed over to the spirit world. May they be met, may they be upheld, and may they be loved by those closest to them. And may those left to walk the long path, may they be comforted, knowing that they are now free of pain, and they are now returned once more to a full state of mobility and health. And we ask too for the animal kingdom, for those dear ones that accompany us, for they pick up on the vibrations of this world in which we live. Bring them comfort, and bring them peace, and bring them healing. But most of all, dear Lord, we ask for ourselves, not in a selfish way, but in a way that help us to be the ones to be positive, to act in positivity, to do things, to help people, to uplift and not to destroy. We ask for this healing balm so that we may be given that strength, that courage to work through these coming dark days and to return to the light once more, rejoicing in our love of the spirit and of the divine. Amen. Just go quietly off just for a few moments now, please, and just send out just love. That's all you need to do. Send out love. Thank you, everybody, joining in, sending out all that love and that compassion. Now hand over to lovely Jan for a reading, followed by her address.
Hello, everyone. The reading I've chosen this morning is from a book called The Power of Now by Urquhart Hoyle. And it's a chapter entitled Beyond Happiness and Unhappiness, There is Peace. The Higher Good Beyond Good and Bad. And it's a question: is there a difference between happiness and inner peace? Yes. Happiness depends on conditions being perceived as positive. Inner peace does not. Is it possible to attract only positive conditions into your life? If our attitude and our thinking are always positive, we would manifest only positive events and situations, wouldn't we? Do you truly know what is positive and what is negative? Do you have the total picture? There have been many people for whom limitation, failure, loss, illness or pain, in whatever form, turned out to be their greatest teacher. It taught them to let go of false images and superficial ego-dictated goals and desires. It gave them depth, humility and compassion. It made them more real. Whenever anything negative happens to you, there is a deep lesson concealed within it, although you may not see it at the time. Even a brief illness or an accident can show you what is real and unreal in your life, what ultimately matters and what doesn't. Seen from a higher perspective, conditions are always positive. To be more precise, they are neither positive nor negative. They are as they are. And when you live in complete acceptance of what is, which is the only sane way to live, there is no good or bad in your life anymore. There is only a higher good, which includes the bad. Seen from a perspective of the mind, however, there is good, bad, like, dislike, love, hate. Hence, in the book of Genesis, it is said that Adam and Eve were no longer allowed to dwell in paradise when they ate of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. This sounds to me like denial and self-deception. When something dreadful happens to me or someone close to me, accident, illness, pain of some kind, or death, I can pretend that it isn't bad, but the fact remains that it is bad. So why deny it? You are not pretending anything. You are allowing it to be as it is. That's all. This allowing to be takes you beyond the mind with its resistance patterns that create the positive-negative polarities. It is an essential aspect of forgiveness. Forgiveness of the present is even more important than forgiveness of the past. If you forgive every moment, allow it to be as it is, then there will be no accumulation of resentment that needs to be forgiven at some later time. Remember that we are not talking about happiness here. For example, when a loved one has just died or you feel your own death approaching, you cannot be happy. It is impossible, but you can be at peace. There may be sadness and tears, but provided you have relinquished resistance, underneath the sadness, you will feel a deep serenity, a stillness, a sacred presence. This is the emanation of being. This is inner peace, the good that has no opposite. What if it's a situation that I can do something about? How can I allow it to be and change it at the same time? Do what you have to do. In the meantime, accept what is. Since mind and resistance are synonymous, acceptance immediately frees you from mind dominance and thus reconnects you with being. As a result, the usual ego motivations for doing, fear, greed, control, defending or feeding the false sense of self, will cease to operate. An intelligence much greater than the mind is now in charge, and so a different quality of consciousness will flow into your doing. Accept whatever comes to you, woven in the pattern of your destiny. For what could be more aptly fit your needs? This was written 2,000 years ago. It seems that most people need to experience a great deal of suffering before they will relinquish resistance and accept, before they will forgive. As soon as they do, one of the greatest miracles happens, the awakening of being consciousness through what appears as evil, the transmutation of suffering into inner peace. The ultimate effect of all evil and suffering in the world is that it will force humans into realizing who they are beyond name and form. Thus, what we perceive as evil from our limited perspective is actually part of the higher good that has no opposite. This, however, does not become true for you except through forgiveness. Until that happens, evil has not redeemed and therefore remains evil. Through forgiveness, which essentially means recognizing the insubstantiality of the past and allowing the present moment to be as it is, the miracle of transformation happens not only within, but also without. A silent space of intense presence arises both in you and around you. Whoever or whatever enters that field of consciousness will be affected by it, sometimes visibly and immediately, sometimes at deeper levels with visible changes appearing at a later time. You dissolve discord, heal pain, dispel unconsciousness without doing anything, simply by being and holding that frequency of intense presence.
Lovely.
I found those words last night. Took me a while to find a reason reading, but I did. Excuse me. But you know, I was sat here thinking last night about the address, and our world is changing. We know it's changing. And it was only 2 or 3 months ago that our headlines in the newspapers were telling us of pollution, of the plastic all over the world, of the ice caps that were melting, of the Amazon rainforest that was being destroyed. And yet we turn the page to the book, because now we're talking about a virus that in some way or another will affect all our lives. I don't know about you, but I found this week a week of very mixed emotions. I'm normally quite a positive person, and I just take things as they come. But like many of you, I felt fear, anxiety, anger, laughter, tears. I know that a lot of you know that I live and work here in the same building, and the residents here are elderly, they're of that vulnerable age. And over the time I've been here, they've spoken of the war years and what happened during the war years, and where they all came together, they all helped each other. But this is different, this is something I see, and I think what we find most disconcerting and hard to comprehend is the isolation. It's you're keeping your distance from people. And they sit in their flats, and a lot of them haven't got laptops, mobiles, they've got phones. But having to sit there day in and day out and not speak to anybody, they find this really, really hard to do. But we are entering a new world. We're in a phase of transition. It's out with the old, as they say, and in with the new. But it tends to overlap. And many years ago, I studied books many years ago. And what I read then is now happening now. And I'm going back 30 years. The spirit time as well is not the same as our time. And these things happening have built up over a period of time. And I know it's scary. I know we don't like being told what to do. But I also find that it's a time of great excitement. For me, I feel it's what I've been preparing to do for years. You know, spirit world is extremely interwoven with our materialistic world now. They're very tough. And there'll be a lot of people who will pick up sensitivity. They will see spirit, which is fine for us that have this understanding, but not always fine for them because they don't understand. And this will cause confusion as well. And it's up to us to reach out to those people and try and teach them and love them and look after them. One thing I think is vitally important at the moment is that we keep the lines of communication open between all of us. Just one phone call takes 5 minutes just to keep in touch with someone and let them know that they're not on their own. We're all in this together. We all want to help each other. There are people that are very scared at this time. It's understandable. As I say, I felt it myself. But we are there. We're all there to help. So please keep the lines of the communication open. Keep sending out your healing thoughts. Because when we sit on our own, for us, it's a time of reflection. And we can send out our thoughts to our loved ones. We can send out our thoughts to the world. Because all this will help. And when this time is over, and when we come together, it won't be a world that we've known before. Governments won't be able to claw back the monetary system because there are hundreds of us now whose livelihoods have gone overnight. They're not in control anymore. They don't know what to do, how they're going to face the next day. But this is all part of our learning. And I say this for experience. It's not something that I've read, because although I read for years and looked at books, I also experienced. So it will be a different world. It will be a new order. Yes, there will have to be discipline, but you know, when we have discipline in our lives, it reduces stress, and there will be a new learning, and people will come together again. And this, I think, is something that we need to hold on to. My heart and my prayers go out to the world. Thank you for listening. Thank you for tuning in. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
Lovely, Jen. Thank you very much. Yeah, you said things that I know have been in my head, and I'm sure many, many, many more people are thinking the same. You know, all that we're going through at the moment is a bit like a period of grieving, because we're grieving for what we've lost. We're losing people. That's the main thing. That is first and foremost. We are moving lovely. We are losing lovely people, and we'll continue to. But the world, you know, I keep seeing people saying, oh, when it gets back to normal. My inner thought is we're not going to get back to normal. We're going to get to a new normal. So we're grieving, you know, not only for the people that we're losing, but for our complete way of life, because it's just so quick. You know, this is not a phased in thing. This is not like the Brexit, you know, timetable of, all right, in December, we're going to do that. In January, we're going to do that. This is overnight. You know, 4 weeks ago, we were walking around the shops, hugging, kissing, laughing, drinking, and now we're not.
I think people are noticing that our whole world has been turned upside down. I think this is the thing. I had a DM speak to me the other day who said, you know, one minute I'm sitting here as if I have nothing to do, the next I haven't got enough time. But this is all part of the transition. We're trying to hold on, like you say, to what we know. And that has gone. That is moving on. But, you know, sometimes I think, were we prepared for this, or did we just not listen to that intuitive voice that was there all the time telling us? And if we're seeing things, and I'm hearing comments of people hearing the birds singing again where they once couldn't. Yeah. There's dolphins swimming in the Grand Canal in Venice. But was that there all the time and we just didn't see it? I don't know. I have my own thoughts of this, like everybody else has their own thoughts. But yeah, there's definitely got to be kindness to one another. There's definitely got to be compassion through this. There's definitely got to be love.
Definitely, definitely, I don't know. Can you see the comment there from Nikki Gaultier?
Yeah.
And she's just mirrored exactly what you just said.
Yeah. Thank you, Nikki. That's great. Thank you very much. You're quite right in what you say. is kindness and compassion that a lot of humanity already show, but we need to teach the others to do the same and to work together. Thank you very much for that. It is very exciting times. I am.
It is. And please, anybody listening and anybody to listen, don't ever think we're devaluing any of the horror of what we're going through and what is to come. Do not think we're dancing on anybody's graves, because by no means are we.
No.
Everybody will be touched. Everybody will be moved. Whoops, here we go. We're no way are we devaluing that, but it's a change. You know, we're going through this huge change. We've been living our lives, you know, basing all our moral ethics and our wants and our sociabilities on all these reality stars, and I want to be like them, and I want to be this, and I want to be that. And actually, do you know what? Best thing in the world is to be yourself.
Absolutely.
You know, we're seeing such wonderful, that clapping. Oh my God, here we go. Sorry, gonna cry. That clapping the other night at the NHS, it wasn't the act of clapping. It was the emotion. It was that energy that was out there. And everybody, I'm sure, had the same sort of shock in a way. I know I did. When I started clapping, whack, it was there, that emotion. And yeah, the fact we're able to actually partake and do something, because everybody's spirit about wanting to do, wanting to work, wanting to be part of it, was made manifest just through that simple act of clapping, you know, and it was absolutely beautiful.
I think the emotion was there. For me that day, I was experiencing anger. Like I say, it's not normally like me. I'm just hoping that it was somebody I was picking up rather than it was me, because I've been told to transmute anger into something positive. And when the emotion came that night, I was in tears, but it's also a form of release. And then once you release that, then you feel better. And there's nothing wrong in showing tears and showing emotion. Because again, it just reiterates to everybody that we are in this together and to be ourselves.
Most definitely. Yeah, most definitely. Interesting comment there from Jane Yigit.
Yeah.
What on earth?
What on earth spirit do you think of this world? Spirit of love.
Yeah.
Spirit of love. And me personally, I like to think that we are the children of the world, whatever age we are. And therefore, we are being taught through love. Spirit only connects with love. And we are like naughty children, aren't we? We've been told to do something and we don't want to do it. But we have to learn. We really have to learn. And I think when this passes, when this, you know, this awful virus has gone, like I say, it will be a new world. So many people's lives have been affected in so many different ways. But like the reading said, you won't be the person you were before. On a deeper level, things would have changed within you. And you will think all that was important to you, all the material side of life, won't be. Won't be. Yes, we need money. Yes, we need food. Yes, we need a roof over our heads. And we will have that. But our whole thinking, and helping humanity is a time that, as I said in the prayer, it's not only now that we stand together, but we will have to stand together always.
Very true. Yeah, very true. You know, everybody is. We've seen before many of the unselfish acts of compassion that people did do for any cause throughout time. But I think now we're actually feeling that, because it's all our emotions, all our sensitivities are suddenly whacked up through the ceiling, because we are all together.
Yeah.
Probably for the first time in history, the whole human race, you know, even at the time of wars, One side would be in their vibration. The other side would be in their vibration. The neutrals would be in their vibration. But now every corner, every centimeter of this planet is in the same vibration. Mm-hmm. We've all got the same fear. We've got the same, you know, for want of a better expression, the same common foe. But we've got that one thing that's uniting everybody, and we mustn't lose that energy ever. You know, it's so important. This is the first time ever humanity is united in one cause. You know, this phrase is saying about all in this together. Yeah, globally.
Globally, exactly.
From here to Russia, to America, to China, to Indonesia, to Australia, it doesn't matter. Everybody is in this together. Yes, the effects will be different for everybody, but the actual cause is universal. So, yeah, this is a time now we are learning huge lessons, evolutionary, spiritually, emotionally. We've all got that opportunity to move forward. You know, Some people will take it, some people won't. Some will be quick on the uptake, some will be slower on the uptake. It doesn't matter.
But I think along the way, we all are going to have to learn to let go. You know, I've given many addresses where I've said to people, you have to learn to trust. The message has been going out for years. It's happening now. You have to let go and trust and let go and welcome in the new, even if it's difficult at this time. Even if you've lost loved ones, you know, send them on their way. Send them with love. We don't want to lose loved ones. We don't want this to happen, but it is, and we have to face that. And I just think that everybody, eventually, maybe not even in my time, will realise that this change that is happening is for the good. I've got a question down here. Yeah. Morning, Neil. Thank you for your question. Yes, you're quite right. Nature always needs to heal, and it does. And we need to balance ourselves as people. We need to balance ourselves. It's very true that some people are very materialistic and others are seen to be very spiritual. But we all have to balance. We have to have that equally within ourselves. And it's bringing back balance and going forward as a complete human being.
Yeah, very good. And balance, as you know, has always been one of my key things in all aspects of our life.
Absolutely.
Balance is so important, you know. Without balance, we can't function properly. Emotionally, physically, spiritually, mentally, it's all about balance. Diane Hubert, beg your pardon, love.
Good morning, Diane.
Hope you're well. Yes. Everyone, I think, is feeling it.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
it is. I think the thing is as well that we know that this virus is out there. We don't know whether, if or not, it's going to touch us personally. And it's like, as I said before, it's something we can't see. So we don't know. We can't give a time limit on this. And it feels at times to me that, yes, it's there, and then it's been worn out. It's testing us. In a way, and I've been fearful too, and I know a lot of other people that have, but this, as I said just earlier, is also a form of release. It's a healing, and I think we have to remember.
Yeah, very true. I always say tears are healing. It's silly little things that move you to tears as well. I'm sure everybody's having the same. Obviously, with the news and the daily updates on the tolls and everything, it's a very tearful, emotional time. But just silly little things, seeing outside. What is it? Here we go. Little pussycat over the road at the garden centre spends its whole life sitting on the counter having a fuss from the customers. Well, obviously, they're shut, and little pussycat sat there on its own. You know, and there's me sobbing my heart out, giving them a big old fuss this morning. And everybody will have all those little triggers and many more to come, just as daftest little thing. Yeah. Tony Goswell. Lovely Tony Goswell.
Thanks, Some people are finding it hard to trust. Understandable because of their fear. I don't know if you remember, Tony, but there is a book out there called Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway. And I think a lot of people, whether they know this or not, will feel the fear and they will do it anyway. And then you'll find there's nothing to fear. Yes, it's difficult to trust. The whole, as I said before, people's livelihoods have been turned upside down. What they had one minute has gone the next. And they're having to trust in what government tells us at this time. And they're not in control. I think this is the whole thing. People are now out of control. This is bigger than what we realized, what we probably envisaged at the time. But there's also a bit much bigger, better vibration, spirit vibration around us, that you have to trust that they are looking after us at this time.
Yeah, very much. And I'd like to just add, you know, those of you who know me know my point of view. A negative energy is a lazy energy. It requires no effort. You know, anybody can come out and sit there and pour out negativity all day. Well, God loves you and carry on with it. We have got access to that positivity, but we've got to actually work at it. You know, we're saying about, yes, there are positives in the situation we're in. We've actually got to look for that, to try and understand it and to make it a positive. You know, because positive energy is a reflection of the energy we put into it. Negative energy is just off the cuff, it's rubbish. You know, all these people finding million and one reasons why they should be able to drive to their favorite beauty spot to, you know, you just stop arguing, stay in. That's all people are saying, is stay in. It's really not that hard, but look for the positive and be prepared to work for that positive. Nice little comment there from Nikki Gaultier. Yeah.
What could have brought us to such an epic shared experience? We're all connected.
Yeah.
Whether you believe in it or not, we are all connected. May not day to day, maybe much more on a deeper level. And we all need to go through, obviously, this experience right now. And I think we've all, even me, well and truly me, have to look at myself and think what I've done. We reflect and we are reflectors of each other. And so therefore, we are sharing this experience.
Yeah, another comment there from Nikki Gaultier's show this morning. Lovely. I love your comments, Nikki. Actually, I'm going to have you on. I'm going to book you for a day.
Are we stuck at home or safe at home?
Perspective is everything.
Yeah. I like to feel that I'm safe at home. I think most people do. But it's your perspective on this. Sometimes we haven't got a choice. As we know, there are a lot of people out there working still and they're not at home. So how must they feel? You know, are you better? I work here, as I say, and I find it actually, for me, better to work because it keeps my mind off things. And I'm here and I'm here to help my residents. But at the same time, there are times when I would be much preferred to be sat up here in my flat. I don't know the answer to that. I think it's your actual perspective on things. How do you feel?
I think that tallies in nicely with what I was saying about the positive and negative sides of things. You know, we've got to work at looking at the positive. Yeah, you can. So it was, again, just highlights what I say. It's easy to be negative. Oh, here I am stuck at home. Mm. No, here I am safe at home. Because when you say you're safe at home, you've looked at, you've done like your own risk assessment on the world. Yeah, and you've worked out that, yes, I'm safer indoors. I'm safer away. I'm safer from picking up contagion from anywhere or anything or anybody. You know, so you've put that energy into it. The negative energy, the lazy energy, I'm stuck here. You know, why should they be telling me to be sat? You know, we're hearing this and seeing this on the streets. You can't tell me to stay indoors. Yes, you can.
as well. I was always taught all through my learning, through different circles and what I've read, to think positive. And if you have what we perceive as a negative situation, you need to try and turn that round into a positive, because those people that are sending out negative thoughts are only going to attract that back to themselves. So if you can teach people and just say, can you look for something positive in what you perceive to be negative, it's a great learning tool. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You can, lots of things going on that end. Lots of absolutely wonderful comments here. You've touched on a lot of... Oops. Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
Good old Susan.
Absolutely true, Susan. Brilliant. Thank you very much for that. Yes, let go and let go.
Yeah.
We've got to do that. Yeah. Brilliant. Thank you.
Right. I think that's roughly it. The viewers are dropping off. So obviously the attention span's waning. All right, don't worry, everybody. I'm doing exactly the same. I've got Charlie sat at my feet. I've got this urge to pick him up and give him a big cuddle at the moment. by the way, those who don't know me, Charlie's my cat, all right? So don't worry. I trapped somebody into lockdown. right, so... Dan, would you like to do the closing prayer, please, my darling?
I will certainly. Please, let's all join together in prayer. Heavenly Father, divine and loving Spirit, we give our thanks and our gratitude for our time together this morning. Give us the courage, give us the wisdom, and give us the grace to work together. And that over the coming weeks, we ask, Father, that you guide and protect us all through your love. Amen.
Just quick mention here, Jane Yigit. Sorry if I've got that name wrong. Apologies. Thanks from Bolton Church. So we've linked up with a couple of other chair. And there was a gentleman on earlier, I believe, from a church in York.
Lovely.
So, yeah, that's nice. It's nice we're all working together. And that's the way it should be. Also, Deb Clark, spiritual medium Deb Clark, thank you for joining us. Of course, the lovely Ashley. Hello, Ashley.
Morning, Ashley.
All those, and if I haven't mentioned you, it's not because I don't like you. I don't remember, you're on camera here. Everything's seen. Yeah. A little bit, the new way of working. But yeah, thank you all for joining us. It's been absolutely lovely. I hope we've all taken something from this. You know what? I always say, if you agree with what we say, absolutely wonderful. If you don't agree, you know what? Even better, because that means you got your own philosophy. So God bless you, you know. Thank you. And we shall say adios until tomorrow evening. I think we've got meditation on 7 o'clock tomorrow night. All right, take care, stay safe, stay in.
Thank you. God bless you all. Thank you.